In the submission style in Vale Tudo fight game, the mount position, also known as Tate Shihogatami, is the most preferred position amongst fighters because of its versatility. The mount position gives you the opportunity to finish your opponent with either strikes or submission. This tape will show you controls, escapes, reversals, and setups to help you improve your skills and game as a competitor or fighter. Train hard, train smart. Hope you enjoy the tape.
Lift, uses the elbow, close, lift. Okay.
Now, if his elbows are down, this is where he wants to be. So for one way for him to escape, he's going to shimmy and get his elbows in like this. Okay, that's what he wants. For me to control, I go one hand up, knee, one hand up, and knee. There's my control. Okay. So once he's here, I'm going to come up and control. If he starts to shimmy again, notice my hands. Stay on top of his head and I keep it here. That way he can't get his elbows in. Okay. This is my control. Then I can start to attack. Or start to punch. Alright? If he's got a really big bridge, I keep my hips down into him. Just like this. And I want to control his head. The position. Alright? Then I can do all my attacks with the choke. Sometimes they refer to these like a face choke, or it's just a pressure, a neck lock, or a neck crank. This is a fist choke. This is a hand choke. Okay. Or we call a lemon crusher. Okay, so this is my controlling position. So his objective now is to roll. When he rolls to the side, I just control and I foot up and I control on the base. When he rolls to his back, I bring it back down and he switches. Just like this, control. And he rolls back. Good. Okay, if he rolls all the way one revolution, I open my base and I let him roll. Okay, he goes the other way. A lot of people lose this position because it stayed too tight and he just does a big bridge and he loses the position. Okay. So what I want to do here is when he moves, I've just got to open my legs, keep my toes in and stay on top. So when he decides to move, okay, if he goes half or full revolution, I'm going to follow. Okay. If he rolls again, let's see, from right here, he comes up to his knees. Watch my toes. My toes are going to come inside. Okay? One more time. So my toes, when I follow, he rolls, my toes come inside, double inside. Okay? Now, I keep my feet clapped together so he doesn't do the loop like that. Toes, loop, scoop, yeah, and bring it in. This is what a lot of people will try to do, is get loose. Okay? Go back. So when he does that, do it again, I just keep my feet together and I can keep my balance and keep it in. This is easy for me to control so he can't loosen it. Then I'd have to start breaking him down, mostly keeping him against the stand your elbows. Okay, so on the back position here, the easiest way to break the person down is by grabbing one hand, okay, and getting my opposite leg all the way through like that. As I do that, it's just easy for me to flatten him out. You have a lot of pressure in the back. Okay. From here, I don't have quite so much pressure. With the foot and leg through like that, one leg wave through, opposite hand, or be the same here. Opposite, straighten him out. Now it's easy for me to roll him. Then I can start to attack the choke.